Fala rapaziada, começando mais um vídeo aqui no canal Na Ponta da Língua e sejam bem-vindos para mais um vídeo. O vídeo de hoje é um vídeo muito especial, tô tendo a honra de gravar com o querido e famoso professor Rui Ventura. Pra quem não conhece, ele é o professor de inglês da plataforma Cultivo. Eles têm mais de 500 mil seguidores aqui no YouTube e o professor Rui Ventura é o professor oficial de inglês lá. Um ótimo professor, a base do meu inglês tá nesse cara. Então esse é o vídeo que eu tô gravando com muito prazer. Algumas semanas atrás eu joguei essa ideia assim no ar, falei que eu tive a oportunidade de conhecer ele. E aí, desde então, vocês não param de me pedir esse vídeo. Então tá aí o mais esperado nas últimas semanas. Bom, esse vídeo vai ser quase praticamente uma entrevista. Separei algumas perguntas pro professor. But those questions are gonna be totally in English. So let's talk in English right now, actually. I'm already speaking English. But before we get started, Rui, do you have anything to tell us?
Hey, hello everyone, how are you doing? Well, it's good to be here. Matheus, thanks so much for your invitation, man. You know, I'm a subscriber to your channel as well, so let me say hi to all of you guys who watch this guy's amazing work. He's doing a great job here, and man, thanks for inviting me. It is a pleasure for me to be here, you know, especially knowing that some time ago we started studying English, and yeah, you saw some of my content in the internet, you know, my classes at Cultivo. Now, having this invitation from you here, you know, it's really awesome. So, thanks again for inviting me around. And I know you got some questions for me, so just feel free to start. Let's see what we can do for you guys.
Well, first, I heard that you created your first English course when you were turning 15. Is that true?
Well, not exactly. No, not exactly. Actually, my way of teaching today is far different from the one I used to when I was 15, which was when I started. Actually, what happens about the 15 age is that that's the moment where I started giving classes. Not at 15, actually, no, a little bit before that, I started helping my friends at school. You know, regular school, I was just a student, but you know, I had been studying for a long while before that. So yeah, I knew a little English. So I started helping my friends at that time, and I saw business in there. Man, no, 14 years old, I can make some money on that. So I started asking my friends for this. No, would you pick me a Coca-Cola and a coxinha, you know, in the break time? And they would say, yeah, sure. So that's where I really started working as a teacher. But yeah, at 15, I started my own business, which is not a school. It was just a classroom that I had inside another school. And that's when I started, but no, that's not the moment I started my methodology. You know, my methodology was built with a lot of experience along the years. What happens is, there at 15, what I did was I just photocopied a book and I started working that book the way I thought it was okay. And if I were to look at myself at that time, I would tell myself, keep on the way, it's gonna work out, it's gonna be good. But don't do that anymore, this is wrong. Do it the other way. That's what I would tell myself if I could possibly visit myself in the past. But it's okay because that was the beginning. And shortly after having my own classroom, I went to a big school and I took some trainings. I learned a lot. My English grew amazingly. You know, I boosted my English like pretty much. And I started really learning how to give a class. And after that, I went to another school and another school and another school. So, and every time I was at a school, I would start as a teacher, and shortly after, I would be the pedagogical coordinator because of the way I always worked. You know, I have always been the kind of person that says, let's make it hard. You know, I like to keep this with me. Work hard, play hard, but when you work hard, work very hard. And that's what I do. So I was always there, you know, studying, giving classes, learning. Studying, giving classes, and learning. Because I knew that someday I would come up with something that would be me, you know, something that would probably outlive me, and it's going to happen for sure. So I can tell you that this methodology that I use today, I've been working with it for all my life, but I can tell you that it started like around 10 years ago. I could say, yeah, 10 years ago, I started, you know, making up my own stuff and say, okay, this is me. This is Rui Ventura. And that's where I started my methodology, the one I work until the date. That's it, but not at 15, like 10 years ago, 29, 30, something of that nature.
Well, but how do you like to teach English? You know, like, how do you like to work?
Well, you know, I like working the way I do. I know that sounds a little bit stupid, right? Of course, I like to work the way I do. Yeah, of course, I love my business. I love my stuff. But when I say that, I mean, I've been through many schools. And when you're working for a school, you know, you have to follow that book, that specific methodology. You have to wear that one size fits all crap and just make students understand that the way the schools want them to learn. And I didn't like that, you know, because many times when I was working for a school, which happened to work only with translations, and then some people didn't like that, but I had to do that anyway. And many times I was working for schools who dealt with a communicative approach. And, you know, some students, they needed the translation. They were like, oh, I'm totally lost here. What am I doing here? And I could not translate. So that was very bad for me. This is one of the reasons why I quit schools and started my own methodology, you know, which is much more flexible. You know, I've got this student, and so I teach him one way. And then I've got this other student who has a different, you know, a way of acquiring things. So I teach him in a whole different way. And that's what happens. You know, sometimes friends come and they study with me. And then one talks to the other and they go like, oh, my class is like this and like this. And then the other goes like, what? Was that the same guy? Because my class was totally different. So I love doing that, you know, having this freedom to study my student. I mean, really, you know, looking into the core of my student and, you know, realizing the way he acquires things so that I can prepare the stuff and give it to him in a way that he may understand. So this is how I like to teach. This is how I like to work, you know, respecting every student's individuality, you know, every student's very specific way of learning. So that's what I like to do, you know, visit each student in the core and see, okay, this is how this guy learns. So this is how I'm going to work with him. I've got students today that have classes with me only with songs. I have students who have classes with me today that I only work with videos, movies, and, you know, the series. I have students who come and study with me and they want to translate everything. I have students that come to me and they just want to chat in English and no practice, and it's okay because I'm free to do whatever, not whatever I want, but I'm free to do wherever it's needed for that student to learn. So this is how I like working, you know, providing the best I can to each of my students.
Man, that's really adorable. So now can you tell us, like, what's your best experience teaching English?
This is very hard to say, you know, it's hard to spot one very favorite moment, one very, you know, touching experience, because in all these years, I've collected thousands of stories, thousands of situations and experiences. I could spend the next maybe 5, 4, 6, 10, 12 hours telling you good experiences I've had in this all this time, but there's one that's not old, you know, I'm talking about 2 years ago now, no, maybe 3 years ago. I used to have a room here in Curitiba where I used to give classes, private classes. And the back of the room, I mean, my wall was a big American flag, not like this one, you know, this wavy flag, but it was a big American flag, you know, it was plotted on the wall. And I had the board on it, and every time my students would go, okay, not any student, but this specific group I'm talking about, I'm sorry, I didn't mention that. So There was this group of five girls, you know, five teenagers, and they still live inside my heart. I still have contact with some of them. I love those girls. But that was a very touching experience because every class that they were there twice a week having classes with me. And every time one of them would go to the board, write something, I'd say, oh, watch the wall, please. Don't write on the wall. I'll kill you. And they would go like, I'm busy there, teacher. I'm not going to write on your wall. So that was the situation. And then when I decided to close that room and I said, okay, I'm going to give you classes in my house now. So I'm closing the room and I have to take this wall, you know, this beautiful flag. I got to take it off. And I told them that. And then when I was giving one of the last classes there, I guess it was the last class. It was to these girls. And, in the middle of the class, man, I needed to go to the bathroom. I mean, desperately, I needed to go to a restroom. And then I was trying not to go. And then I said, girls, look, I'm so sorry, but I gotta go to the toilet. Hold for 2 minutes, I'll be back. And then one of them said, Hoy, can I write something on your flag? And then I said, no. And then she said, but you're going to take it off and throw away. He said, yeah, you're right. So yeah, you can write on my flag and that's okay. And I went to the toilet. When I came back, all the wall, all the flag had messages like, thank you, like, we love you, like, nice messages. And that was very touching. That was a great experience. And by the way, you know, here in my room, I have that wall. I have that flag here. I'm going to take a picture so that you can see this flag with these messages. So I guess this was one of the most incredible moments I've had in my life of teaching.
Now I'm very curious about that question. How was your experience working at Cool Teeth?
If you allow me, let me make a correction in your question, right? Because it was not how was working with Cuchivi, how it is working with Cuchivi. Why? Because 4 years ago, I was invited by a friend who happens not to be there anymore. But, you know, he invited me saying, Hoy, you know what, we've got this project and we're going to deliver free courses for people who can't pay. I said, okay, I'm in. That's all I need to know. I'm in. And there I went. So I was one of the first teachers to start, you know, having the classes prepared. So it was very nice. Many mistakes happened. And it was a great experience at that moment. You know, we recorded like 260 something classes. And these classes have been amazing and helping so many people. And that makes me happy to the date. And what happens is, you know, when I partner up with Cuchivi, what happened was I got to be kind of famous, not famous, not very famous, but many people know me today because of the work we had together. You know, to the date, we have 570,000 students having the English course. And yeah, now let me say why I'm correcting your question, because that was a great experience, but it's still a great experience because right now, at this moment, I'm recording a second English course with Cuchivi, not for Cuchivi, but with Cuchivi, and it's a pleasure. You know, the guys there are amazing. All the people involved there are fantastic. I had the pleasure of meeting some of the most amazing people I've met in my life working there, and they're all my friends. I love them all. So it's a great experience, you know, being part of that. It's, man, it's just a pleasure. I don't have words to express myself when talking about working with Cuchivi. That's just amazing. Well, what can I say? Thank you again. But now I want to talk to you in my own language. Galera, muito obrigado, tá, pela audiência aqui. Matheus, cara, mais uma vez de coração, obrigado, obrigado. Foi realmente um prazer participar. Espero que vocês aí, que são os subscribers aqui do Matheus, da Ponta da Língua, tenham curtido aí esse pequeno bate-papo. E, cara, acompanhem o Matheus, porque assim, ele faz um trabalho incrível, tá? Ele é muito mais que só um aluno que foi tentar aprender. Ele tá aprendendo e ao mesmo tempo tá ensinando vocês. Então, continuem acompanhando, que esse cara vai longe demais. Matheus, mais uma vez, cara, eu vou cansar os ouvidos da galera de falar muito obrigado, cara. Realmente é muito legal pra mim estar aqui, né? É, como você comentou num vídeo, pô, eu estudei com o cara e hoje eu sou amigo dele. E é muito legal ter esse contato com você, cara, e assistir esse teu crescimento, né? Você tá aí com um canal com, cara, 30 e poucos mil seguidores, incrível. Eu tenho 5 mil seguidores só no meu canal do YouTube e você já tem aí 30 e poucos. Eu fico muito feliz com isso, cara, muito feliz mesmo. E esses 30 vão virar 300 e vão virar 3 milhões, porque esse conteúdo que você leva pra galera engaja muito esse povo e traz informação importante para eles, tá? Então, pessoal, para você que acompanharam aqui, obrigado, valeu de coração. Acompanhem lá os meus trabalhos com a Contive, acompanhem também o meu Instagram, né? Arroba Professor Rui Ventura, e o meu canal do YouTube, que também é youtube.com.br/professorruiventura. O que vocês precisarem de mim, eu tô à disposição, tá? Lá no Instagram, todos os dias tem postagem, todos os dias tem expressão nova. Aqui no YouTube, todas as semanas eu dou 3 aulas ao vivo para vocês acompanharem. Estão super convidados a participar. Todo domingo, toda segunda e toda quinta-feira tem aula ao vivo aqui comigo. Matheus, cara, obrigado, obrigado demais. Foi um prazer. E todo o sucesso do mundo para você. Valeu!
Bom, agora seguindo o fluxo aqui no português mesmo, Rui, não tem nem o que falar, cara, o prazer é todo meu, fico muito feliz mesmo de ter você aqui no meu vídeo hoje. Já te falei isso várias vezes lá no WhatsApp, no Instagram e repito aqui em vídeo. Pra mim, tu é referência, tu é um ótimo professor, não só como professor, mas uma ótima pessoa também. Não é à toa que muitas pessoas, muitos alunos, assim como eu, gostam demais de você. Então, cara, de coração mesmo, muito obrigado pela participação, muito obrigado por ter topado fazer esse vídeo aqui junto comigo. Bom, galera, se você gostou desse vídeo, deixa seu like aqui embaixo, compartilhe com algum amigo seu, óbvio, vai estar me ajudando muito. Se você não me segue ainda, não esqueça de me seguir no Instagram, o link vai estar aqui na descrição. E é isso, galera, vejo vocês no próximo vídeo, tamo junto e valeu!